the reality is, if Rangers fans dig into every single season with their expectations just a bit too high, they go into it expecting that Rangers should be challenging. And I think that's where the downfall comes. You know, they always end up being disappointed with their team because every year they go in with their expectations too high. And actually almost compare them to the Man United fans down in England, where they seem to do the same. They're not the same club they were, you know, 15 years ago.
Celtic have been financially much better off than Rangers for a long time now and have dominated the game. They are going, they hope, for their 12th title out of the last 13. But you have to be careful because, you know, Rangers are on the 90 minutes away from winning the first trophy of the season. A trophy that Celtic couldn't get because Clamarnock knocked them out. The league race got a bit to go yet. The Scottish Cup is still to come. So I do understand that the rules of the bragging rights game, but your call is an elaborate wind-up.
But then I think you could say the same about Celtic in Europe as well, because I think every single season that Celtic fans also go into Europe expecting far too much when what actually is possible. If they went in with the expectations a bit lower, then they wouldn't be so disappointed every year.
Do you think that is true though, Declan? So you're a Celtic fan, we're not doing the bragging rights thing. When you say Celtic fans are expecting too much in Europe, is it too much to expect that you at least just finish third in a Champions League group?
You look at just the difference in the Europa League wages that some of these teams that make it out to the group stages and make it further on. You know, they are far superior in terms of what money they bring into their club every single year than what Celtic do. Now, I know you can say Celtic done it, Rangers done it a couple of years back, but that's really not going to happen too often, is it?